All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Mark Gibson, the COO of Cordoba Minerals Corp. And Mark, it's good to see you. How are you?
I'm very well. Thank you, Steve. And how are you?
Good, good. So you've announced some initial drill results from the Alacran deposit. And maybe before we get into sort of what you saw there, maybe tell me a little bit more about the program and the design of it.
Well, Steve, we're doing this program, 40,000 meters worth of drills, the largest that Cordoba has ever done. And we're doing it to support two objectives. The first is our feasibility study that we announced early this year. And the second is to get the EIA, the government permit that we need to actually build the mine. So those are the two objectives. We're focused right now on the first 25,000 meters of that program. And we've released the first assays that we've received from the initial 6,000 meters or so of that.
Yeah, so let's talk about the results coming out of there. And I know that you had sort of a pre-feasibility model that you were sort of going by, and now these results have really sort of aided in that as well.
Yeah, they've been a great correlation of that initial model. So we hit mineralization when we expected. The grades were pretty much correlating directly with the block model. We exited mineralization when we expected to. So, you know, great correlation, great confirmation of the resource statements that we've been putting out. And we look forward to further confirmation as that drilling continues.
Yeah, let's talk a little bit about what's ahead, because I know that there's a number of catalysts that you have coming up, and you mentioned feasibility, and obviously that's going to be a big one for the company.
That's right. Yeah. So that's what we're objective, the overall objective that we're working towards. We will be putting out a lot more drill information as the months go by, because obviously the drills are turning. We've got six rigs on site. They're all turning right now. So as those assay results come back, we'll be putting a lot more information into the market than we have been in previous months. And all of that will be supporting the feasibility study that you can expect to see early next year.
There's a lot of things around that that have to happen. The environmental impact assessment is one. Can you talk a bit about the work that needs to be put into that as well?
Well, all of this is supporting the EIA, the Environmental Impact Assessment. So partly that's going to be the technical drill results, the resource update that needs to go into there. Metallurgy is part of it, geotech, hydrogeology, hydrology, as well as interacting with the communities that are in our direct footprint, getting their buy-in and having a negotiated solution for the community that's actually living on top of the deposit right now.
So a lot of the companies that we talk to are very early stages or working towards something. You're getting set to start mine construction in the next, you know, foreseeable future. So maybe just give us sort of a timeline as to what you have here, because I know that 2023 and 2024 are going to be very big years for Cordoba.
Yeah. Now, obviously, all of these timelines are subject to governmental approvals. So, you know, we don't get the PTO and the EIA in the timeframe we anticipate. Then that would put the construction decisions back. But we've already submitted the PTO. That is the program of technical work. So the government is currently reviewing that, and we expect to receive a decision in the next few weeks to months from that. So the current drilling will be going on for at least another 4 months, so until the end of the year. Along with the other baseline studies that are part of this feasibility. That will take us through to a feasibility that is published next year. That will form the basis for the EIA submission. Once we have the EIA, we'll be then doing detailed engineering. And the most optimistic turnaround we would expect is that construction decisions potentially would be at the end of next year. But I think more reasonably unlikely it would be beginning of 2024.
Okay. And just lastly, I just want to ask you quickly about the drilling results we talked about earlier, the grades that you're seeing. You're very happy with where they're at, and because you obviously will have a lot more coming out in the next few months.
Yeah, there are a couple of different aspects to the drilling that we've seen. The one is that we're seeing a great correlation with the block model, and that was obviously part of the headlines. The second is these CBM veins, the carbonate-based metal veins. Now, in 2017, we put out this bonanza intersection of 0.9 meters of over 4 kilograms per ton of gold. It was quite extraordinary. And we've intersected several more of those CBM veins in the years since then, but they've almost been completely random. We've not really seen any correlation between the holes. And as a result, they've been excluded from the existing resource statement. What we've seen with the current drilling is that they're starting to become more predictable. So we're definitely seeing a correlation between those veins and the high-grade parts of the block model. But furthermore, there seems to be some sort of north-south linearity to that that might make them more predictable. Now, of course, if we can start to predict both their orientation, their continuity, and their grade, we can bring them into the block model. And that would be a fantastic upside for us. Obviously, we're still some way away from there. They remain excluded, but it's something we're now actively, for the first time, I could say we see a path towards that, which is a fantastic opportunity for us to pursue.
Absolutely. That's why the drilling in the next couple of months is so important for sure. Mark, thank you so much. Great to catch up with you. Appreciate the time.
Great. Thank you, Steve. See you next time.
All right. Sounds good. Mark Gibson, the COO of Cordoba Minerals Corp.